Hi nerds, hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel. Today we are going to be doing a vinyasa sequence. We're going to be kind of doing it a few times in a row, but to start we'll come into an easy seat. So have one foot in front of the other, don't want stacked legs or anything today. So one foot in front of the other, we'll start with our breathing. So we're going to really gently arch as we inhale, warm and wide, let everything in your pelvic floor, low belly expand, and exhale, squeeze everything in and out as you gently curl the upper back. Inhale here, exhale. Not going too deep right now, just gentle cat-cow. Exhale. Now here we'll circle forward, exhale back, circle, maintaining that breath, squeezing everything in and out as you wave back. And switch directions. One last time here. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Namaste, and twist to the right. Just holding that twist, holding it with our oblique muscles. Keeping the hands at the heart center so we don't use our arms to yank or twist. We're just using our core muscles for a moment. And back to center. Now we'll switch leg that's in front and do it again. So inhale here, exhale, inhale, exhale. Starting to warm up the spine, get the breath going. And inhale as you wave forward, exhale as you circle back. You don't have to worry about too proper form here, just kind of feeling the spine as it's moving, circling around. Inhale last time, exhale, back to center. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, hands come to your heart center and twist to the left. From here, you can even wave the spine tall. Make sure that you're not slouching down in it, anything like that. Perfect. Come back to center. We'll get a little warm up of our core. So we're going to come onto our sits bones, just feet out in front of you. Recommend putting your, actually put your fingertips behind you, you're gonna want them there for support, and come up into your Navasana boat pose. See if you can hold it there for a moment. We are going to inhale as we lengthen out, come onto the right hip and exhale, bring the knees in. Then we'll inhale, lengthen out again, exhale, come to center, inhale, lengthen out, and exhale the other direction, and back to center. So you see, fingertips for support is really good. If you want the challenge, you can try it without your hands, but I want to make sure that you are protecting your spine and, you know, working your core with a solid structure and foundation more so than like, ooh, look at me, I'm not using my hands for support. You're getting good enough workout just doing this. But this way, we're supporting our spine. Keep breathing here. Last round, back to center, hold it. Now that we've done that, now if you want a challenge, you can release your hands. See if you can hold it, even bring one foot up. Switch it, switch sides. And awesome, just come into a goddess pose for a second. Inhale here, exhale, wave gently. Just rocking back and forth. Awesome, and then you can stretch. Stretch out the belly that we just worked so hard. Awesome, and then make your way however you need to get there to your down dog. Really grounding into the earth with your fingertips here. and gently coming onto the palms. You don't want very much weight on the heel of the hand. You really want to be suctioning in with your fingertips and the ring of your palm. And pedal out your feet here. Starting to warm up the calves, the back of the the backs of your legs. And wave the spine, get some nice length in this pose. Then inhale here, bending everything, getting real close to the earth using momentum and physics, and wave yourself forward to your plank. Knees tap onto the ground, lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, you can roll yourself into cobra or up dog, whatever you're feeling. And from here through pointed plank, make your way back to down dog. Very nice. So inhale here. Again, bending close to the earth. And inhale, right leg comes to the sky. Just for a moment, you can open the hips to the side and let that right foot fall behind you. Remembering to keep that breath going that we practiced in the beginning of class. Come back to center, squaring out the hips. Inhale here, exhale, bending everything and bring the right knee to your chest. Inhale back up, exhale, inhale here. Last time, exhale, stepping the right foot through to the right thumb. Inhale here, prepare, wave the spine long. Bend the back knees, you roll yourself in and up to your high lunge. So start with that bent knee, find the good position in the hips, then extend the spine and the arms unfurl last. Now from here we're gonna inhale, straighten everything out, we'll do some fists of fire lunges and we're gonna go all the way to the floor. So inhale here, exhale, just tap the floor with your knee, inhale up, exhale, inhale last time, exhale, tap the knee to the floor and inhale here. Exhale, plant hands back to the earth. Step yourself back to plank. Come back onto your knees. Lower through chaturanga. Inhale here. Exhale, wave yourself in and up and make your way back to plank. Or to down dog, excuse me. You can exhale, lion's breath. Sigh it out and then inhale here, prepare. Inhale, left leg to the sky. Again, you can open your hips for a moment. Let that left foot fall behind you. Stretching it a bit more. And come back to center, hips square off. Inhale, left leg tall. Exhale, bending everything, coming through knee to core for core plank. Inhale, lift back up. Exhale. Really bending the knees when you're doing this. Give yourself enough space to exhale. Knee to core, and then step the foot forward to the left thumb. You don't want it in the center of the mat. That'll put you off balance, and it'll put you out of alignment. So left foot to left thumb. Inhale here. Long spine. Bend the back knee. Wave yourself in and up. Now that we've got our hips aligned, lengthen the spine, then unfurl the arms, then straighten out the back leg. From here again, we'll do our fists of fire lunges, tapping the back knee onto the earth. So inhale here, exhale, just gently touch. Inhale, come all the way up, exhale all the way down. Inhale last time, exhale. Inhale back to your high lunge and exhale. Plant your fingertips onto the earth. Really strong palms. Step back to plank. Knees on the ground. This is good for your shoulders. Lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, rolling in and up. And make your way back to down dog. Awesome. Pedaling out the feet. And from here, come onto your knees. Walk back or sit back into child's pose for a moment. Can even rock your hips back and forth if you want. Do a lion's breath and sigh it all out. then really grounding into the earth again with your fingertips, strong rings of the palms. Make your way back to down dog. Inhale here, prepare. Wave yourself forward, come onto your knees, lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare, exhale, rolling in and up, and then make your way back to down dog. Inhale, bend the knees, right leg lifts to the sky. You can open your hips again, let the right foot fall behind you. Come back to center, inhale, right leg lifts, exhale. Remember to bend your knees and your elbows to make room for core plank. Exhale, core plank two. Last time, core plank three. Step the right foot to the right thumb. Inhale here, prepare, long spine. Bending your back knee, rolling yourself in and up. Finding that stable aligned position of your hips, spine, and arms. Unfurl here. We'll do our lunges again. This time, if you want a different challenge, we'll do our fierce mudra. So really pressing out through the palms of your hands. So inhale here, coming all the way up. Exhale all the way down to the earth as we fierce mudra. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale last time. Exhale. Awesome job. Inhale up to high lunge. Exhale back to your plank. Right foot steps behind you. You come onto your knees, you lower through chaturanga, inhale here, prepare. Rolling in and up and making your way back to your down dog. Bending everything, left leg lifts high, open the hips, drop the left foot behind you. Back to center, left leg lifts tall for your tripod dog. Exhale for core plank one. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale up. And exhale, core plank three, lifting in and up, and step the left foot forward. Inhale here, prepare long spine. Bend the back knee, rolling yourself in and up to your high lunge. And from here, we'll do our fierce mudra again. So again, really pressing that through the palms. So inhale up. Exhale, fierce mudra, tap the back knee. Inhale up. Exhale. Last time, inhale here. And exhale. Make your way back to your high plank. Back to your high plank now. And coming through your chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Rolling yourself in and up. Back to down dog. And make your way back to your heels for child's pose. If you want, you can even sit up on your heels, shake out your hands, massage out your wrists if you need. We're gonna do it one more time through on both sides. All right, so once you feel like you've caught your breath, you're ready for our last round, walk yourself back to your down dog. And from here, inhale, prepare. Remember to bend everything and wave yourself forward to plank. Come onto your knees, lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Roll yourself in and up. Exhale, back to down dog. Right leg lifts to the sky. You can open the hips. Let the right foot fall behind you for a couple of breaths. Square off the hips again. Right leg lifts up and exhale for core plank one. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale last time, core plank three. And step right foot to right thumb. Inhale here, prepare. Bending the back knee. Rolling yourself in and up. Now this will be our maximum effort round. So we're going to do pulses. So come onto the earth, tap the knee, and do pulses. Awesome. Back to plank. and lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare, rolling in and up. Exhale back to down dog. Last side, yay. So bending towards the earth, left leg lifts to the sky. Open your hips for a moment. Let the left foot fall behind you. Feel that nice stretch for a couple of breaths. And square the hips back to center. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, core plank one. Inhale, exhale. Last time, inhale up, exhale to core plank three. Step left foot to left thumb. Inhale here, prepare. Bend the back knee. Wave yourself in and up. And our maximum effort round on this side, so you're gonna inhale here. Exhale, just tap the right knee to the floor and that is it. Woo! Make your way back to plank. Come onto your knees. Lower through chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, roll yourself in and up and back to down dog. Definitely take a lion's breath and sigh it all out. Stick your tongue out. This time we'll walk your feet forward. Come to sit. Just let your knees fall open to God's pose. We'll do some cat-cow. Let our breath come back. Awesome. And make your way down onto the earth. Hug your knees. You can rock back and forth. From here, we're going to take our right ankle over our left knee and pull our left leg towards us. You can grab on the shin, you can grab behind the leg. You can even stay here if you feel the stretch. Wherever you need to work, this is where you gotta hang out, but we're trying to get a stretch on the right leg. And we'll switch sides. Again, stay here. If this is where you feel the stretch, you don't wanna go any farther, definitely hang out here. You can also pull the knee in closer. Just depends where you're feeling the stretch today. All right, gently release that. Now from here, you can lift both legs up, almost like doing a forward fold. If you're starting to feel a stretch in the backs of your legs, hang out here. Don't go any farther. If you want, you can. Otherwise, you can start pulling your legs a little bit closer to you. If you can reach your toes, awesome, but you don't have to. And just start pulling your legs towards you, feeling stretch in the backs of the hamstrings, maybe your calves if you're holding onto your toes. And from here, if you really want a challenge, you can even open the legs and rock back and forth. It's a great inner thigh stretch. And then take yogi's choice. If there's any other stretches or poses that you need, feel free to take that now before coming into your final resting shavasana. Hope you enjoyed that practice. Take all of that strength and maximum effort with you through the rest of the day. Make sure that you are subscribed to the channel so you get notifications for all the new videos, and make sure you're on the League of Nerdy Yogis email list. That way you get all the exclusive content that you've got there. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you on the mat next time. Namaste.